I'm going to make a call to a restaurant that I've had a terrible experience at, and then we'll take it from there and see how it goes. But again, this is live, and we have not recorded this or practiced it. So, guys, if we can get the demo agentic AI ready, and I'll place the call then to, I don't know, Bloomberg Kachina Bloomberg, and see if I can get through. Can we place the call? This is using PolyAI's agent and software.
Good afternoon. You have reached Charlotte, the concierge assistant for Restaurant Cucina, Bloomberger Rosendale. May I confirm, is this Mr. Tom Mackenzie?
It is, yes.
Wonderful, Mr. Mackenzie. I see you last dined with us on the 11th of October, along with Mr. Johnson and a party of six. How was that experience for you?
Yeah, not Boris, by the way. It was an awful experience. I mean, the food was okay. To be fair, the food was pretty good. The service was terrible. And you stuck us next to the toilets. And you just got that smell throughout the whole meal. So, yeah, not best impressed, honestly.
I'm truly sorry to hear that, Mr. Mackenzie. That's not the standard we pride ourselves on. May I ask, was the issue with the seating or service addressed on the day?
The manager said they would address it, but we continued to have bad service throughout the day, and we were never moved away from the toilets.
I'm truly sorry the resolution fell short. We'd like to make it right. As a gesture of goodwill, we'd be delighted to offer you a 20% discount on the tasting menu for your next visit. May I assist with arranging a new reservation or answer any other questions for you today?
Okay, 20%. Okay, I'm a sucker for a deal. So, I could rebook for 20% if the service is better and if we get a different seating arrangement as well. So, okay, we can do a booking. So that was a yes to the 20%.
I'm so glad we can welcome you back, Mr. Mackenzie. Let's make sure we create the perfect experience for you this time. May I ask if this is for a special occasion?
It is, actually, yeah. It's a colleague's leaving party.
That's wonderful. Let's make it a memorable farewell celebration. Could you share the date and time you have in mind for this special occasion?
How about November 7th? 7:30?
Certainly. And what time were you thinking on the 7th of November?
7:30.
Thank you. And how many guests will be joining the celebration?
Let's make it four.
Perfect. So that's a party of four on the 7th of November at 7:30. May I take your preferred contact number just to confirm the booking details?
I think you have it in the system already.
Absolutely, Mr. Mackenzie. We do have your details on file. Let me summarise. A party of four on the 7th of November at 7:30 for a colleague's leaving party, and will ensure a better seating arrangement and apply the 20% goodwill discount on the tasting menu. You'll receive a confirmation email shortly. Is there anything else you'd like to add, such as dietary preferences?
That sounds good for now, thank you.
Perfect. We look forward to welcoming you. You'll receive a confirmation email shortly and we'll ensure everything is set for a wonderful evening. Thank you again, Mr. Mackenzie.
Actually, there was one last thing in terms of the decor. Can we do something on the decor around the table?
Please go ahead. What else can I assist you with?
If we could get some, I don't know, pink frills around the table, golden balloons, and a bottle of Barolo.
That sounds like a lovely touch.
While
we don't do decor directly, we can arrange flowers or decor through our trusted partners with advance notice. I'd be happy to pass your request on to our team and they can coordinate the details with you via email. Would that work for you?
Yeah, that works.
Excellent. We'll ensure the team follows up with you to perfect those details. We're all set, and we'll make sure this is a truly special evening. Thank you once again, Mr. Mackenzie, and we look forward to welcoming you soon.
Okay. Thank you very much. Do you need to pass me on to a colleague or anything else? Are we done? Is the booking done? Apparently so. All right, let's see if the experience is better.
The booking is fully confirmed, Mr. Mackenzie, and you're all set. You'll receive the confirmation shortly. And if you need anything further, we're always here to assist. Thank you once again, and we look forward to your visit.
Okay, well, that was our demo. Thank you very much indeed, Bloomberg Kachina. And let's bring on then the co-founder of PolyAI and the CTO, Shawn Wen, now, who can talk us through the technology behind that agentic AI. Shawn. All right, Shawn, thank you very much indeed. So I was pushing there because there was a moment you told us that there were two AI agents, and we were hoping that agent one would pass me on to agent two. So maybe I didn't give the right cues or the right prompts to get to that point.
Indeed.
Because there was a fabulous Northern English accent that was going to pick up and confirm my pink frills and gold balloons, which I was quite excited about. Shawn, talk to us about this. What is going on? What is the model? What is the technology behind this?
Yeah, so you know, this is what we call the agentic systems, right? So technically, it's an AI system that powered by LLM, but it does a lot of autonomous decisions by itself within certain kind of guardrails. So the kind of use case we designed to trigger is that if you ask for private data dining room, it will actually hand it off to that northern voice that you like, and then you will go through the private data dining experiences.
Ah, okay.
But because it's a small group, it doesn't suggest you the private data dining, and then therefore it doesn't actually trigger.
So if I'd said private dining, that would have triggered, and that agent would have passed me on to another agent.
And if you say more than eight people, they will say, oh, eight people, it would be great fit for our private data dining, so that you would actually try to book you in that dining room.
Okay.
So it's that little details that you know.
Yes. Yeah. They're important in that respect. How much of that agentic AI to agentic AI is becoming commonplace in terms of agents passing on to other agents?
Yeah.
Is that something that we're seeing more often, and how technically challenging is it?
Yeah, so the kind of system you see, right? So there are a couple of technology behind the scene there. So first of all, it has this personalization capability. So it actually understands is you, Tom, calling in from your phone number. So we can do a lot of personalizations with that based on the contact details you have stored on file. So that's the one thing. The second thing is that this kind of system, it has becoming, is a traditional, the traditional system is more cascaded systems, much more modularized. Now this system is integrated into one. So much better at making turn-taking decisions and understanding your queries. Lastly, you also hear that there's also emotional touch to it as well. So it can actually understand your emotions and change accordingly to it. And your question about multi-agent system, in fact, we are seeing more and more in our use cases. And this kind of application we are supposed to show is the one-to-one agent-to-agent handoff. But actually, a lot of our use cases is actually about one-to-many agent handoffs. So these are usually cases we see a lot in retail use cases and also in healthcare use cases, where you will have typically a master agent taking the phone call, taking the query from the user, and then the master agent will launch several outbound smaller agents to actually call suppliers in the background to check, whether the product user is inquiring for is actually on the inventory or not, or whether the health care plan the client is requesting for is actually applicable to different clinics so that the agent can make those recommended decisions.
So you talked about healthcare there and you talked about retail. Where are the biggest, are those areas where the biggest demand is right now? Where are you seeing the most traction for this right now?
So healthcare and retail definitely are quite big. We also see quite a lot in the financial services as well. Mm. And in fact, tomorrow I'm going to a panel with HSBC and NVIDIA as well about how to deploy these agents in the financial services.
How difficult is, or how important is it to get the accents right as well? Her accent, it seemed, changed to me a little bit towards the end of the call. I don't know if anyone else picked up on that, but it seemed to adjust a little bit in terms of our accent. Is that technically a challenging thing to do?
Yeah, so getting accent right used to be quite difficult.
Yeah.
Like with the technology improved, you know, a lot in the past, like 1 to 2 years, getting the accent right is a lot easier now. Typically now, what we do with our clients is that we will actually present 3 to 5 different voices to them. And sometimes they can say they don't like any of them. They want their own voice actors or whatever. Then we can work with their voice actor to do a voice clone. And usually it just takes a couple of sample of the voice. Of course, the more data you have, the model will stick to that voice a lot more, and it's less variant. Mm. So when you hear there's a British accent switching to Australian accent, just because, you know, the model has seen both, and it kind of makes sense to stitch them together. So there's
stitching together of an English and an Australian accent.
Because it's a common thing it has seen.
We're running out of time.
Yes.
Very briefly, what does this look like in 5 years' time? And does this mean massive job displacement?
Yeah. I think, you know, when we first started, we have been asked a lot of these quick questions, like 7 years ago, like, is this AI going to actually replace humans' job? It's actually arguably a very tough question to answer. But now, since we have deployed thousands of agents in the world, and then also, like, we have some agents that does the job of 1,000 people as well. What we found and collect feedback from our clients is that this agent deployment don't usually directly replace jobs, because, you know, enterprise typically just like deploy these agents and then they feel good about it. They gradually slow down the hiring or not hiring anyone anymore. Yeah. And typically we see that there's a sweet point where they are usually businesses are happy to pay certain amount to continue to deliver like human touch.